Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. For without faith, it is impossible to please God. For whosoever must come to him must first of all believe that God is, and God is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. For to him that believes, all things without an exception is possible. Or you can live in the realms of possibilities, for that is what heaven now is all about. In heaven, all things are possible. Faith for heaven now is having the required spiritual force of faith that you need to have life as you want it where you are. In heaven, God our Father has life as he wants it. In heaven, God is not perturbed because of any issue. Why? Because faith is in full display in heaven. Look at the Bible, 1 John 5 and verse 4. The epistle of John chapter 5 and verse 4. For whatsoever is born of God, look at the word. He didn't say whosoever. Whatsoever is born of God overcome the entire world. That means whatever is happening here on earth is not to disturb you at all. Kano labrahandia karutekestemeba meli itwa kadazusia. Whatsoever is born of God overcome the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. When you have faith, you live as a victor, not as a victim. When you lack faith, you will remain a victim, victim of circumstances, victim of Satan, victim of situations, victim of men. Nothing handicaps destinies like unbelief. Nothing distorts God's agenda for a man or woman like unbelief. When Jesus saw their faith, he forgave the man's sin and he healed him instantly. When Jesus saw unbelief, he walked away from his own people in Nazareth. He marveled at their unbelief and could do no mighty works among them, and took his leave and went elsewhere. When you live in unbelief, you push God away from you. I pray this thing will sink. When you walk in unbelief, you push God away from you. Jesus came to Nazareth, where he was brought up. As his custom was, he entered the synagogue, and the book of the prophet Isaiah was given to him. And when he had found where it was written, he read what was written for them to hear. What did he read? The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach the good news or the gospel to the poor. I have come to stop poverty. Christ announced to their hearing. That was where the poorest of the poor resided, in Nazareth. The poorest of the poor dwelt in that city, and God gave him the solution, the anointing to change their story, the anointing to lead them out of poverty, the anointing to break the hold of poverty over Nazareth. He told them, I have been empowered, energized, equipped, anointed by God to preach the gospel, the good news to the poor. What is the good news to the poor? Your era of change of story is here. You cannot remain poor again. You will be enlisted as the richest people on earth if you will hear what I say and do it. He was anointed, he told them, to preach the gospel to the poor. to heal those who have been struggling to pay medical bills without success, to heal the brokenhearted and sick, to preach deliverance to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind. Jesus told them he has been sent to set at liberty those who were crushed, bruised, and oppressed by the devil. He said to them he was sent to preach the acceptable year of the Lord, to announce jubilee, the year of freedom for all, the year of liberty for all, the year of blessing for all, the year of restoration for all. That was what Christ came. And he closed the book and began to tell them, today is this word fulfilling your ears. What was God looking for? Faith comes by hearing. Hearing by the word. You have heard what God said. Believe it. Believe it. If you believe in the Lord thy God, you will be established. If you believe in his prophets sent to preach or proclaim the word to you, you will prosper. Where you are, your prosperity is tied to the gospel you hear from the mouth of his messengers. Jesus told them the words they heard, they didn't mix with faith. The words they heard, they didn't mix with faith. So they struggled in their poverty, died in their sicknesses, remained in their captivity, remained under the oppression of the devil, and Christ couldn't help it but walked out on them and went away. How can you come to your place where you know their situation to change their story and you again leave them? Only unbelief can make that happen. Many have lost God today. You know why? Because of your unbelief. My prayer for you is that whatever may have been responsible for your living in unbelief be destroyed right now in the precious name of Jesus Christ. This is faith for heaven now. God said when we pray, we should say, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name." Your life is to bring honor to God. But hear me, you can never smell honor without faith. Jesus said, if only you will believe, you will see the glory of God. God crowned man with honor and with glory when man was made. Psalm 8, from verse 3 to verse 8. God crowned man with honor and with glory. Anywhere you see glory, you see honor. Anywhere you see honor, you see glory. What is it that attracts glory? Faith. After Lazarus died and was buried and had been in the grave for 4 days, Christ appeared. He was told this man had died and had been in the grave for 4 days. He said, if only you will believe, regardless of where he has been buried, you will see the glory of God. What attracts glory is faith. What pushes away your glory is unbelief. When you lose faith, you lose glory. When you begin to live by faith, you recover your glory. My prayer for you is that your glory will be recovered and restored today in the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus could do no mighty works in Nazareth, in Mark chapter 6. From verse 2 to verse 6, they saw the mighty works that Jesus did, and they marveled at his wisdom. Yet, in his own place, he couldn't do mighty works. Why? Because of their unbelief. The same word that could have given them results, they heard it. It was spoken, but they never saw results. Why? Because of no faith. Many of you have heard so much. Many of God's sons and daughters, they have heard so much, but why have they seen so little? Unbelief. Because unbelief stops you from taking the required faith. From taking the required faith you must take to see God work for you. If you hear the word and you don't choose to live by faith, you don't choose to do what you have heard, you will never see God. It is not those who hear that are blessed, but those who believe and they do. So, we are talking about faith for heaven now, because once you believe, all things are possible for you. Your problem is not because of where you are. Your problem is not because of your enemies. Your problem is not because of the economy. Your problem is not because of those who are fighting to make sure you go down. Your problem is your unbelief. If you can believe, all things are possible. My prayer for you is that regardless of whatever is going around you, that you believe. For whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. When you begin to live by faith, you conquer cheaply. You become a cheap winner when you begin to live by faith. One day, the Lord told me that his greatest secret is faith. I said, how? He said he never doubted anything the Father said. And he said to us, if only you can believe and be converted like a child, that's just faith. He said, you, if only you can be converted and become like a child, you can live here on earth and see heaven in reality. What hinders us is unbelief. A child believes all the Father says. A child does not doubt the Father. When you begin to believe God, listen, you attract God to you. You commit God to your affairs. Nothing pushes God away from you like unbelief. Nothing attracts Satan to you like unbelief. Anywhere you see unbelief or fear, there the devil works. Job suffered all the losses he suffered because of his fears. It was fear that attracted Satan the devil to Job, and Job began to lose. Listen, if only you can believe, whether you are in the belly of the fish, that fish will vomit you. If only you can believe, even if you are in the grave, you are coming out of the grave. If only you can believe, even if you are where you have failed like Peter, at the next step, based on the word of instruction from heaven, you will see flourishing in what you do. Listen to me, faith is the thing. The church is struggling today because of unbelief. The church is where the church is because of unbelief. If only you can believe, all things are possible. My prayer for you once again is that no matter what others do, that you believe God. If only you can believe, I tell you for my God will move you from where you are to where you never thought you can get to in your life this year. Hear me, hear me well. If only you can believe, my God will push you up into realms of living that you will be wondering how you got there. Faith is the key. Faith is the key. To him that believes, all things are possible. The victory that delivers you from being a victim is called faith. The victory that conquers the world is your faith. The victory that conquers the devil is your faith. The victory, what puts you in perpetual victory over disease, is faith. I have not known sickness. I have not been swallowing drugs. You know why? It is faith. It is faith. If you can believe, all things are possible. We do not walk by sight. We choose to walk by faith. In other words, we don't allow what we see to dictate what we say or what we do. Faith is the key. My prayer is that you will rise up from this meeting and tell yourself, I believe it shall be unto me as he has spoken to me. Jesus said unto him, if you can believe, that's all. Can you believe? If you can believe, all things without an exception is possible to you when you believe. Jesus said of them, the reason why you failed in your assignment is because of your unbelief. For verily I say unto you, if you have faith as a grain of a mustard seed, you shall say to this mountain, remove hence, you will speak to that obstacle, leave my house. You will speak to that devil, get out of this place. You will speak to that challenge, depart from me. You will address your mountain You will say to your obstacle, you will speak to your challenge, you will speak to your enemy, you will speak to your adversary, you will speak to every gang up of hell against your life and destiny. You will speak to them, remove from my house, remove from my job, remove from my career. Every set up of hell, go out of my way. Go to yonder place and he shall remove. What you address will move. Listen to me. Today, you are going to pick a challenge of life that is tearing you at the face and address it. This is practical. You can create what you want. All you need is faith in your heart and the word in your mouth. You can create whatever you want. All you need is faith in your heart and the word in your mouth. For with the heart man believes and he is made right. And with the mouth man speaks and then he can get whatever he wants. Listen to me. If you have faith as small, as tiny, as a grain of a mustard seed, you shall say unto this mountain, gigantic problem, what you know your father saw, your mother saw, maybe your grandfather, your grandmother saw, and you are seeing it, and it has remained like a mountain, like a barrier between you and your destiny fulfillment, between you and your financial explosion, between you and your career lifting, whatever you have seen, that is the challenge you are facing. God says, if you have faith as tiny as a mustard seed, you will speak to this mountain, remove. Come on, pick something now. Now, whatever, if you can type it, you can say it right now, not after now, right now. Pick up a challenge. It could be lack. It could be want. It could be disgrace. It could be shame. It could be reproach. It could be needs. It could be problems. It could be anything. Enemies. It could be a mindset. What you know is standing between you and success. Pick one now. Let's address it. Can you shout about Hania? Pick one challenge of life that you feel is stopping you from moving forward, from advancing. Pick one in the name of Jesus. I like it after me. This mountain, name it. This barrier, I remove you by faith in Jesus' name now. This barrier, I remove you now. In the name of Jesus, I believe in my heart what I've heard. Now I speak to you, mountain, get out of my way. You sickness, get out of my way. You lack and want mentality, get out of my way. You blindness, dullness of my mind, I speak to you, get out of my way. Every unbelief, whatever hinders people, I remove you. I declare you removed right now in the precious name of Jesus. He said, you speak to the mountain, remove hands from here to yonder place. Tell you where to go. Go to the abyss. Go to where you came from. Any arrow of hell shot at me by the devil, I return you to where you are coming from right now. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I join you and I declare your settlement in life and finances. I decree your settlement in life today and in your finances. Every financial obstacle, every financial challenge, every financial barrier, every financial mountain standing between you and your finances, whatever the devil may have placed before you and your finances, I remove it from your pathway. I send it back to the camp of the devil right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever is opposing your financial blessings, working against your financial blessings, whatever is standing between you and your financial explosion eruption, in the name of Jesus, I remove it from your life, from your mind, from your heart, from your family, from all that concerns you, from your job. Every lifestyle that hinders financial eruption, whatever it is, doubt, worry, anxiety, sorrow of heart, fear, whatever is stinginess, selfishness, whatever is causing you not to prosper financially, in the name of Jesus, I decree that they are removed right now. In the name of Jesus, because I decree that they are removed right now, right now, right now, right now. I remove every barrier between you and your financial harvest. In the name of Jesus, every financial season is to attract and bring to you a financial harvest. Whatever is against your financial harvest, based on the seeds you have sown already, I decree and remove right now. I speak to every barrier in your career. I speak to every barrier in your business. I speak to every barrier against you. I remove them right now. I command them to depart from you, never to return to you. In the precious name of Jesus Christ. And so it is done. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, whatever is stopping you from doing God's work as you desire, today I remove them. In the name of Jesus Christ, whatever is putting your life under pressure, causing you not to do what you should do for God, right now I remove them. I remove them. I remove them. I remove them. I move them out of your way. Whatever is opposed to you from serving God as you desire, maybe pressure of work, maybe lack, whatever it is, today I address those mountains. Be removed now in the name of Jesus. I remove them. This is the victory that conquers the world, that overcomes the world, even your faith. How do you give expression to your faith? By what you say. When you say it, believe it, and it shall be so. When you speak to the mountains, believe in your heart and do not doubt, and you shall have whatsoever you say. Having addressed whatever is against your eruption in life, in finances and in God's work, I decree they are gone and gone forever. In the precious name of the Lord Jesus Christ, hear me and hear me well. From today, you walk triumphantly, gallantly, sweatlessly, stresslessly into your place in life, in your finances, and in God's assignment for your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I declare you will never be under any pressure. From now, pressures, they are gone. If they obey and serve, they shall spend their days in prosperity and their years in pleasures. Everything that compels you to live under pressure, they are removed from you right now. In the name of Jesus Christ, God has given you faith. You engage that faith by what you say. From now, never close your mouth. Get up and address any issue. If you sense anything you don't want, address it. If you sense within you whatever you don't want, address it instantly. Don't accommodate any thought that contradicts the best life. Hear me and hear me well. Never you accommodate any thought that hinders you from living the best life. The thought of lack hinders you from giving. The thought of it's not possible that hinders you from taking the steps you should take. All those thoughts, address them. Any thought that contradicts the life of glory, the life of prosperity, the life of comfort, the life of heaven on earth that you desire, open your mouth and address them. As I'm speaking right now, I am speaking to every challenge of life that has worked against you in time past. Never again will you smell them. The victory that conquers the world is our faith, given expression with our words. What we believe in our heart, given expression by what we say with our mouth. When you believe it and you say it, you shall have it. When you believe it in your heart and you say it with your mouth, you must have it. I decree from now, you are going to see the reality of heaven now. You cannot be Christ's ambassador and suffer what Christ cannot suffer. It's impossible. You cannot be Christ's ambassador, committed to the mission of Christ, and suffer what Christ cannot suffer. It's impossible. You cannot be Christ's ambassador, living for Him, and go through what Christ cannot go through. It's impossible, sir. You cannot be committed to the vision, mission, assignment, and mandate of Christ as He was committed to the same and not be given all Christ was given. Hear me well. Your problems come to an end when you sign up and become his ambassador, his mouthpiece, his representative, his messenger, eager to hear what he says and do it. Listen, in terms of money, you will never lack money. In terms of grace, you will never lack grace. In times of freedom from stress, you will never lack it. Whatever God will give to Christ, God will give to you when you are and you live like his ambassador. My prayer for you is that you will realize that ambassadors live to enjoy all that their nation offers. So when you become an ambassador of Christ, you live and enjoy every blessing of heaven in the now. Heaven now is for Christ's ambassadors, not for everyone. You can be a Nigerian citizen in US and struggle like a Nigerian. But when you are Nigerian ambassador to US, your problems are over. Your problems are over. Even if you came from the poorest home or family, once you are sent as an ambassador, your problems are over because your nation takes care of you, meets all of your needs. When you sign up as an ambassador and begin to live like one, eager to hear and to do what God says, God by himself will personally meet all of your needs. Christ by himself will personally meet all your needs. I pray that faith for heaven now will help you to see the need to be his ambassador and settle down to live to serve his purpose where you are. If you do, it will be over with problems, with challenges, with needs, with lack and want, with sickness and disease, with every evil that people are going through today. My prayer is that you will hear. A faithful ambassador is heard. A faithful ambassador is always full of wisdom because the king tells him all he wants him to know to be able to live for him and represent him. A faithful ambassador is always supplied fully with all he needs, so they are wealthy. They don't live looking for money to do their work. No ambassador of any nation sent anywhere looks for money to execute his assignment. Never. They are given. So they enjoy health. They enjoy access to wisdom and revelation, and they enjoy excessive provisions and supplies at will. Even before the need arises, ambassadors are given all they need. I pray for you that no matter what, you will sign up and begin earnestly to live like an ambassador. Lord, what would you have me do today? That's what we say. What would you have me do today? Who must I speak to today? Where must I go today? What must I say today? How do I do your work today? How can I please you today? If this becomes your way of life, I tell you, you will become God's number one, topmost priority. And if that becomes your position and portion in life, your problems are over. I pray for us today. I pray for us today that God will help us not to fail him, but to be his ambassadors in the name of Jesus Christ. Grace to live, to do his will, we receive it afresh this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. Grace to serve him as never before, we receive it this morning. Wisdom to know what to do and what to say and how to do it and say it, we receive it right now. May you flourish. May you receive grace. May you receive everything that heaven can offer for you to be all God wants to be. May you enjoy topmost attention from heaven today. May God supply all of your needs today. May God heal you of every sickness today. May God remove you from every evil trap set for you today. May God cause you to triumph where you have been a victim. In Jesus' mighty name, may you not smell troubles today. May you see peace. May you see bliss. May you be delightsomely blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Experience favors that you have never imagined is possible. In Jesus' mighty name, may you step up and take your place in destiny, living as an influence over all where you are. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are declared blessed. Peace and enjoy all God has for you today. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Peace and God bless you. Do have a lovely day. I am expecting your testimony, because as you begin to think and begin to talk and begin to walk and live as an ambassador, watch it, all of your needs shall be met according to his own riches in glory by Christ Jesus, as he has said, and so shall it be for you. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. Peace. Have a lovely day.